Question number 131. Which device is required to be deployed into an Azure virtual network before you can connect to it using a VPN? Option A, Azure Application Gateway. Option B, Azure Firewall. Option C, Azure VPN Gateway. Option D, Virtual Network Peering. The correct answer is option C, Azure VPN Gateway. Azure VPN Gateway is required to connect an Azure Virtual Network, VNet, to an on-premises network or another VNet using a VPN connection. It establishes secure, encrypted tunnels over the internet or private networks, enabling hybrid connectivity between cloud and on-premises environments. Question number 132. What is the main advantage of using spot instances in the cloud? Option A, they are always available. Option B, they provide significant cost saving. Option C, they offer the highest performance. Option D, they are ideal for applications with strict performance requirements. The correct answer is option B, they provide significant cost savings. Spot instances in the cloud offer significant cost savings because they allow users to bid on unused computing capacity at a lower price. However, they can be interrupted by the cloud provider if demand increases, making them ideal for workloads that are flexible, such as batch processing, data analysis, and non-critical applications. Question number 133. One of the benefits of cloud computing is that you can use a command line script to create or destroy virtual machines in a programmatic way. This is an example of what type of manageability benefit? Option A, management of the cloud. Option B, management in the cloud. The correct answer is option B, management in the cloud. Management in the cloud refers to the ability to control and automate cloud resources programmatically using tools like command line scripts, APIs, and infrastructure as code. This allows for efficient deployment, scaling, and deletion of resources without manual intervention. Question number 134. An Azure blank space is a logical division of a virtual network. Option A, IP address. Option B, firewall. Option C, subnet. Option D, network security group, NSG. The correct answer is option C, subnet. A subnet is a logical division of a virtual network in Azure, allowing you to segment and manage resources more effectively. Subnets enable better security, organization, and network traffic control within a virtual network. Question number 135. The blank space model is a framework that outlines the division of responsibilities between a cloud provider and its customer. Option A, GDPR. Option B, shared responsibility. Option C, serverless. Option D, pay as you go. The correct answer is option B, shared responsibility. The shared responsibility model outlines the division of security and management responsibilities between the cloud provider and its customers. The provider manages infrastructure security, while customers are responsible for securing their data, applications, and access configurations. Just a quick reminder, if you don't want to watch all these videos and instead download all questions and answers, then feel free to purchase them on Buy Me a Coffee page. I have shared the link below. Question number 136. What is the primary purpose of Azure B2C? Option A, to allow employees to access company resources from personal devices. Option B, to manage identity and access for external partners and vendors. Option C, to enable your organization to provide identity and access management for your customers. Option D, to provide identity and access management for internal users. The correct answer is option C, to enable your organization to provide identity and access management for your customers. Azure B2C, business to consumer, is designed to manage authentication and access for external users, such as customers, allowing organizations to implement secure and scalable identity management for consumer-facing applications. Question number 137. Which cloud model typically utilizes the consumption-based pricing model? Option A, public cloud. Option B, on-premises. Option C, hybrid cloud. Option D, private cloud. The correct answer is option A, public cloud. The public cloud typically uses a consumption-based pricing model, meaning customers pay only for the computing resources they use. This model allows for flexibility, scalability, and cost efficiency, as users can scale up or down based on their needs without significant upfront investment. Question number 138. Which of the following is not an example of an Azure resource? Option A, a storage account. Option B, an Azure subscription. Option C, an Azure SQL database. Option D, a virtual network. The correct answer is option B, an Azure subscription. An Azure subscription is not considered a resource. Rather, it is a container that holds Azure resources and provides access to them. Resources in Azure include storage account, virtual networks, databases, virtual machines, and other services that run within a subscription. Question number 139. What is the primary purpose of multi-factor authentication, MFA? Option A, to simplify the login process for users. Option B, to add an extra layer of security to user accounts by requiring multiple forms of verification. Option C, to eliminate the need for passwords. Option D, to protect against phishing attacks. The correct answer is option B, to add an extra layer of security to user accounts by requiring multiple forms of verification. Multi-factor authentication, MFA, enhances security by requiring users to provide at least two forms of verification before gaining access to an account. This typically includes something you know, password, something you have, a phone or security key, or something you are, biometric authentication. Question number 140. Microsoft Intranet Domain Services, MDS, is a managed domain service that can be used to Option A, replace Active Directory Domain Services, ADDS, entirely. Option B, only support cloud-based applications. Option C, extend ADDS to the cloud. Option D, provide a completely separate identity system from ADDS. The correct answer is Option C, extend ADDS to the cloud. Microsoft Intranet Domain Services, formerly Azure AD Domain Services, allows organizations to extend their on-premises Active Directory Domain Services, ADDS, to the cloud. It provides domain join, LDAP, NTLM, and Kerberos authentication without needing domain controllers in Azure. This is useful for legacy applications that require traditional AD features but are hosted in the cloud.